Welcome back. This is Innk, and in today's problem, we're going to find VL and VX. VX is the voltage across the 4 kiloohms resistor. VL is the voltage across the 2 kiloohms resistor. We see that we have a dependent and an independent voltage source in the following circuit, so nodal analysis seems to be the best method. In this case, this terminal connects the VX, we can call it, or the 4 kiloohms, the 3 kiloohms, and the 2 kiloohms. And it seems to connect a good amount of components, so that would be a good terminal to choose. But if we want to know VL, we definitely want to know the voltage at that terminal. So we have two unknown and two equations. So we can call this V1, and we can call this V2. But then again, if we call this V2, well, we're just mixing the variables. So we can call this VL, and we can call this VX. Now we have two equations, two unknown. And those two equations, the unknown is the variables for the terminals or the unknowns. So thus won't cause any confusion, and it will be a little bit more aesthetically pleasing to the eyes, if I may say. So at VX, we would apply KCL, and that would be the difference between the VX and the voltage source. We've seen a positive terminal, that would be a positive 1, so VX minus a positive 1 divided by 2. This would be VX with reference to ground, so that would be 0 volts. So let's do that, and just let's, while we're writing, VX, not V1. So that would be VX with reference to V, which is 1 volts divided by 2 kiloohms, plus VX over 4 kiloohms, plus VX minus VL all over 3 kiloohms. So VX, that portion, we get that. And we get that. So now I'm on to V2, or in this case, VL. And VL is VL minus the dependent voltage source, which is 3VX, and that's divided by 1 kiloohms, plus VL minus 3VX all over 1 kiloohm, plus VL minus 2 kiloohms is equal to 0. For VL minus V, see, in this case, that is VL minus VX. So VL with reference to VX all over 3, whoa, so that should be 3 kiloohms. So VL with reference to VX, VL with reference to the dependent voltage source, and VL with reference to ground all over the 2 kiloohms equal to 0. Simplification, we have VX, and that would be 1 over 2 kiloohms, 1 over 3 kiloohms, 1 over 4 kiloohms, plus VL, negative 1, 3 kiloohms, and that is equal to 1 over 2 kiloohms. We could find a common denominator, in this case 12. Simplify that, and so on and so forth, and multiply through by 12, and simplify, just basic algebra, It's a little bit of algebra gymnastic. Again, we have Vx, negative one third, or negative one third kilo. Not sure if that's saying it correctly, but it would be negative one divided by 3 kilo ohms. Plus Vl of 1/3 kilo ohms, 1/1 kilo ohms, 1/2 kilo ohms is equal to zero. Simultaneously solving these equation, two equation, two unknown, we get Vx is equal to 1.0476 volts. Vl is equal to 1.905 volts. So here we have Vx, and to find Vl, basically the voltage at terminal Vl is the voltage across the 2 kilo ohms resistor. And that's it. See you in the next problem. Bye.